Fresh off of his victory, John Boehner has retained the speakership. You know, we told you about that earlier this week. There were several challengers considered the largest rebellion against the Speaker of the House in 90 years, 25 votes going against John Boehner. Now the strike back has begun. John Boehner wrote down the names of those who tried to take him out of his seat, and now he's launching a counterattack. Two members who ran are now being taken away from the powerful House.
One who ran and one who supported him,
I should say, yes. Right. Are being taken out of their positions in the House Rules Committee. That's Florida's representatives Daniel Webster and Richard Nugent have both been taken out.
Webster ran against him.
Ran against him,
and
yes.
And Nugent supported Webster.
Exactly.
And the rules, that's a very valuable
Very influential
seat, and he took it away.
Yeah.
And now the reaction from the other guys, you know, from the Louis Gohmerts and from the
Yohos.
Ted Yoho. By the way, I'm so glad the Yohos are back. The Hostess took those away.
I know.
A little part of me died, yeah.
Yeah. They're not happy about it. They think it's something out of communist Russia.
Steve King also, yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. So Boehner has begun the strike back. We have some hints about potential future strike back as well, but I do want to play some of Gohmert and Yoho's response. They are not happy that they're now being singled out for opposition to Boehner and his policies. You'll see that in this clip.
We were going to work together after the battle was over. Then we're told it's not over. We're going to screw you over. And it's one thing when you get hurt on your own exercise equipment, but it's another when your own speaker does it to you. So
he's either throwing Harry Reid under the bus or possibly Bono.
I'm
not sure.
The guy is so exceptionally dumb. It's really staggering. He was a judge. He sentenced people to prison.
Judge.
I mean, I don't even really understand what he's saying. Now, I know he's pretty bright.
I think
that's
a
layman, but... I mean, what is he really? This is politics, of course. You cross somebody, and they're going to try to get you. That's politics 101. Is he pretending that he doesn't know what the game is?
No,
is that
he's trying to get sympathy? You win or you die.
It's all horseshit. It's all horseshit, and mostly it's horseshit from him because he's being dishonest now too. He says he recounts these bullshit conversations with Boehner, where like give me a wide shot here, where you know he reaches across. And he was like, I looked him in the eye and I was like, you won the fight and I look forward to working with you. And Boehner said, I look forward to working with you. Who gives a shit whether that conversation took place?
Which
and everybody
didn't.
Knows that doesn't matter.
Right.
That's okay. You can shake for the cameras.
Right.
But I mean, Louis Gohmert knows, right, that this was a possibility.
Yeah.
And the flip side is, though, Boehner knows that then the guys who you screw over get to go on TV and complain about getting screwed over.
Yeah, right.
That's the whole thing.
It's just
part of the daily deceit,
yes,
handed to the American people, handed to the American media, it's eaten up.
Yeah.
No one's being honest. No one says to him, you knew this would happen, and now you're doing the thing that you do to get back at him, right? And I'm a conduit for your nonsense. I'm going to do something else.
So there's a follow-up, I believe, in this clip. Yoho is going to give
him. I'm sure he'll tell it like it is.
If Webster and Nugent are being punished, then we're going to have another fight real quick, and it's going to be pretty nasty. We can't let that stand if they're going to be punished.
You know, I'd like to weigh in on that, Sean, because the American people sent us up here to do a job. They wanted new leadership. We stood up and we voted for that. We brought forth a movement. 25 members of Congress voted the way their representative, they voted the way their districts wanted to. And to be held in jeopardy for that or retribution is wrong, because that would be something you would expect in China, Cuba, Russia, or in a communist country. To, when you have a voice of dissension, you'd be punished.
Right.
But in America, where we honor free speech and a constitution that protects that, we should not have to go through that.
What is his IQ? 80? Russia's not communist, A, right? And Cuba. Cuba. And so,
like he knows anything about what happened.
He can't even get out the whole sentence. He can't make his... He can't even come close to making an overarching point in this. And by the way, 25 people, whoop-de-freaking-do.
Exactly.
And how do you know how your district wanted? Did you poll your district? All your district
about whether they wanted John Boehner as speaker? Most of them couldn't even name John Boehner.
The American people most certainly did not vote for change in Congress in November of 2014. They couldn't have made it clearer that they did not want any change in Congress. They voted for John Boehner. I can't believe there's somebody that Louis Gohmert found a colleague to do a press conference with who was dumber and uglier than
maybe,
he was.
Maybe
it's
that's
hard
why
to do.
He's standing. I think Gohmert's
I know
uglier,
now you're going to dismiss everything I said because he's ugly, but the fact is he's an exceptionally unattractive man.
I think Yoho more attractive than Gohmert.
No, get out.
I
put
think
the shot up
obvious.
Again.
Gohmert's got the. I mean,
that's crazy.
Yoho's got the height. We're not comparing me and Ben.
He's got the height. He's got the way Herman Munster had height.
Yeah, he's a more attractive guy.
No, Gomert is far more attractive. It's not even close.
I mean, honestly, we have the same argument every day. I can't. There's nothing that I can add to this conversation.
Look, he's got no eyebrows.
Guys argue which two other old straight guys are ugly.
Now, many people believed with quite a few sort of Tea Party firebrands, I guess, getting elected both on the Senate side and the House side, that they would then have more power.
Nope.
It turns out that's not actually the case. And in fact, John Boehner makes that pretty clear in this quote. Or actually, I should say it's a leadership aide who I believe is channeling the thoughts of John Boehner. We don't need these fringe guys as much as we did anymore. Speaking about the Tea Partiers, we can let them walk on certain bills and it just won't matter. That gives us breathing room. And then John Boehner, in response to sort of the criticism that Gohmert and Yoho and others have launched against him for engaging in this sort of political strike back, says, "We're going to have a family conversation about bringing our team together." So I guess he's going to bring them in a room and say, look, this is the way things are going to be. And there's already, by the way, conversations about the potential monetary consequences of having gone against John Boehner. They're talking about targeting some of the donors to people like Webster, perhaps Gohmert and others, and try to eliminate some of their funding. Which is significant.
Yeah, yeah. My hunch is
losing a committee chairmanship or committee position is one thing. Losing your entire seat in Congress is another.
I don't know how well this analogy works, but there are some, you know, the way that most progressives are unhappy with most of what Barack Obama has done. Many Republicans incredibly disappointed in John Boehner, and we're desperately looking for this sort of thing.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, put people in their place, man. You're the boss.
Mm-hmm.
Act like the boss.
And he did.
Yeah.